got yourself a gun.
Yeah.
Got yourself a
so
gun.
So I'm living in this time behind enemy lines. So I got mine, I hope ya.
Got yourself a gun.
You from the hood, I hope ya.
Got yourself a gun.
You want beef, hope ya.
Got yourself a gun.
And when I see you, I'ma take what I want. So you try to front, hope ya.
Okay, we're back and we have more information than we had before on this entire chemical thing. This chemical thing has been an illusion thus far. It's been a mysterious thing. But if you're talking about skinny, it's not gonna be a fart. It's not gonna be gas. It's not gonna be flesh. It's most likely gonna be a chemical clog. First and foremost, how to discover a chemical to begin with, and we can do hold your breath, and two fleshly cells that you do have, tooth and flesh. If you held your breath, if anything were to be clogged, the time frame of holding your breath, they would most likely unclog. We can move over to the green eye debate, which has prayer before conception. And that green eyes and a brown skin mixed child is usually prayed for before conception. Brown eyes, their brother, does not like green eyes. He feels that he has been left out. And yet, one notch up going into Africa does like green eyes. And they perform a lot with the green eyes. But what they do is they switch that communicative valve going one notch up. And they go to lower back chemical breathe, camel's nostrils. Now lower back is going to have a chemical, which is a neutralizing chemical for those mixed hardships that people go through. And the fact that brown eyes didn't like green eyes, and they usually stick to their saying. So what we do have are the lighter skin, more black people changing without knowing it, the communicative valve, and still using lower back chemical breathe, camel's nostrils. Okay, and then we're going to go to what we think is the front. And we have white bellies for penguin, and we have white bellies for Tony the tiger. And we have white belly for hammerhead shark. And white belly is really just going to reveal the outline of shoulders to pelvic. So we're going to now go over to shoulders to pelvic, and we're going to say shoulders to pelvic, can't use shoulders to pelvic to hit the brain tree. We're going to inch close to our black side, and we want to denote, when we use our black side saying shoulders to pelvic, can't use shoulders to pelvic to hit the brain tree, that something pops up. Some kind of sterile stimulant nerve ending. Okay, we want to denote that. I'm going to show that the front waistband is going to be then associated with, the front of the belly is going to be then associated with the side of the hip and the waist, and now lower back. And so you have almost a brim level at that point. Okay, and now we're going to go to some other interesting information now that we're kind of familiar with. In fact, it's not going to be a flesh, it's not going to be a gas, things are clogged, it is going to be a chemical. Okay, and where to find those chemicals at. Okay, now we're going to go to the coconuts. And why coconuts? Because this is kind of a touchy subject, but mixed people, especially black and white, we'll use black and white first, because they have the easiest components to switch these coconuts. So we use North Africa, Morocco at this point. If a North African Moroccan wanted to switch to coconuts, it would be very easy and light feeling. But if red and black tried to switch to coconuts like them, they would get a worse forehead. Okay, and so there is a tubing, a lining that allows for the entire mixed body to do things exactly like that. And we suspect that it's because of communication within the mixed world that people look pretty much run down and skinny can't remember anything. Their memory glands have been absorbed and swished up and taken to other parts unknown. And so they could seem a little bit different, a little bit odd. We just want to write these down and on them. Okay, so being familiar with lower back chemical in our mixed world, we're now going to go to the Chinese camels versus North African camels, and we're going to attempt to show that the communications that go on from within are known about. Okay, and other people may actually know about these things and use them against you. Using outside influence, one would always have a disdainment towards that and produce a defensive posture, flesh, thick skin, and or chemical. Now, the communications have to be known about. It's known that the body is going to try and switch dizzle if we're too deep into a conversation using our male and our female estrogen while being mixed. And it's no different for black and red people having male and female estrogens. Now, what we call our black side at this point is a very interactive social element within the mixed world who does not mind being social. And when it comes to switching those coconuts within the red and black worlds, they are very much a key, very happy component. I call my black side the Prince of Lisa, because the Prince of Lisa likes to get into communications. He likes to dream about what societies are like. He likes to interact with the other components, and what happens is at the time frame of being deep into these elevations that a switch of posture within a double state, a switch of posture within a tri-state at this point, squeezy spores, one of the squeeziest spores that you can have thus far, a teeny weeny nick would destroy the rest of that ongoing process. Okay, so basically in a red and black person, once they get into these communicative spores, they are emulating societies, and now the Chinese female and black male, which is the most average, are now the Chinese male, and they become Chinese male by simply using the hormone of black, and therefore you get a worse forehead. Now, denoting the Prince of Lisa, denoting the actual interpretations going on, which are the communications from within, the valves of switch dizzle are very average. The white male mixed with black, oftentimes from a very youthful time frame, wouldn't even know it and would send all his hormones over to the black female, and he would be almost a black male, and would prefer, that I can think of, living in a more comfortable environment due to the surrounding environment and stuff like that. So that's it's very typical to have that component. Knowing that component, what we're going to attempt to do is show the Prince of Lisa communicating with China. We're going to reposture ourselves, and we're going to look for the vertebrae of Asia. I don't mean to say China at all. I mean to say Asia on a more broader scale, just simply Asia. And we're going to try and cross back over to where we were coming from before, now having the correct communication and the correct valves understood. And we're still going to go back now to what is the lower back area. We're going to get into a Cherry Coke bottle in a minute. And we're going to use Camel's Nostrils, lower back chem. Lower back chem. And that's still a Camel's Nostril. So now we have two lower back chems and two Camel's Nostrils at the same time. Okay, back to the Cherry Coke bottle. As we position our body in the beginning of our time, we're going to be somewhere in Mongolia with a Northern Asian people, some black and some white, when they completely wig out and nobody knows exactly what happens. We're going to say something different. We're going to say there's vertebral bloating. We are going to say that there's a lower back chem when dealing with night at this time frame. Something that stresses the people out and closes one of their nostrils. Happens to be the nighttime. We're going to say that happy black deeds, being oneself as a black person, could help this situation slightly, as because when you can be yourself, both nostrils seem to come out. And when you can't be yourself at night, if anything is hesitating, anything holding it back, they close one of those nostrils and they go through a spazoids. But okay, so let's go to Cherry Coke bottle, and let's say that shoulders, the pelvic are outlined. Asian shoulders now can't go up on this Cherry Coke neck past African shoulders to pelvic, without producing those hourglass shapes and now eyes. And you're gonna get a cap off a Cherry Coke bottle, and you're gonna get a cap lid twist swig, and you're gonna get a brain and a heart. And the brain and the heart look the same in North Africa. But again, shoulders to pelvic, and Asian can't go past African shoulders to pelvic going up without producing a empty quarter, an empty location, and hourglass eyes. And so we're gonna look at that framework as being very typical. We're also gonna look at pre-designated postures, meanings, and show that those communicative vowels are very similar to the palm tree coconut switch dizzle valve, or communicative vowels at prayer before conception, green eyes, not locked by brown eyes, and how to remember all of those things together. Okay, now that we are pretty much understanding the posture, the nature, we can also go over what is a squeezy spore and why squeezy spores exist. If we took 250s in the mixed worlds, they would always be just tri-state. And polymer rock can be one of our examples. Earth would separate the fire from the water. The last 50s wouldn't be able to reproduce what the first 250s produced, and the last 50s would be red and white. You wouldn't be able to produce what the Earth separates the fire from the water does do. So you get the concept of a vertebrate bloating. You get the concept of a fraction 2-3 within a 2-5 element. And we can add on to that with chemical smearing thus far. And note that we're not going for the heart at this point. It's smarter to use the brain. Okay, so let's look at chemical smearing. Red and white would produce the anatomy of black in the mixed world. Black and white would produce the color red with no anatomy. 250s again would produce a tri-state. What are we seeing here? That's what I'm looking at too. We're looking at several different mind states, several different computations, computing, and yet being devoured because they simply couldn't add up within a vertebral bloating. So vertebral bloating is definitely going to be a part of that situation, and it's going to be a part of the squeezy spores, which are sporical inner light gathering agents thus far. One who squeezes hard simply is producing necessity. They're producing the initiative, ingenuity to press forward at that time frame. But what we're getting in the mixed world squeezes, where we're getting a huge amount of multiple calculations thus far. And so those are noteworthy and have been mapped out within a mathematical digest. Okay, we haven't failed to see that part. That was good. Okay, onward. On our campaign, we are going to discover what is the avocado fruit. Avocado fruit is very beat up looking fruit, a very skinny looking fruit. Almost looks like a tri-state vertebral bloating fruit. Only difference is that this fruit is poisonous to a bird, and this bird happens to have a horn on its heel. Dubai has a horn on its heel. And we want to circle that horn on the hill. We want to look at that bird every once in a while, and just accept the fact that the reports that have been coming in are that the bird follows people, takes very precise notes, and then uses those notes against people. And if that ends up being true, then we have the Bible gives us that the story of Joseph. Joseph goes into Egypt. He has several visions. Joseph means bird. He's also a dream interpreter. And one of his dream interpretations is that the bird comes in after the accusation of another guy and comes in and eats the brains of the people. However, we happen to be in North Africa at this time frame. There's no pun to hammerhead shark, in which direction we're trying to go into. Of course, we're not trying to go in a very deep direction. In that direction, we're just not necessarily being mixed quantums that we have going into Africa. But in the story of Joseph, at least gives us some insight as to what it might have been like all over the place. It might have still been that same chemical feeling. So these chemicals might have been around yesterday. A lot of people are just learning about them today. Okay, so we have discovered that the this avocado fruit did not come up in Egypt at this time frame. Actually, this avocado fruit is rare to America, and it's from Mexico. Okay, next we want to show Texas off a little bit. Texas, tech simply means to be bound and squeezed. Tech, bound and squeezed in hieroglyphic and Hebrew. It also means low land, like decks. Like the deck of a patio would be a lower portion. They just discovered the biggest crystal caves right underneath Texas in Chihuahua, Mexico, and we'll show that off. Also, 200 feet underneath that area is a river of lava. I'm not sure if you're familiar with Ghostbusters, but Ghostbusters goes to Manhattan and finds a river of plasmic cell types, which communicate with people and respond to people and respond to music also. And so all that is significantly American at this point and can show off the history of anybody who has been bound and squeezed. Okie dokie, I think roughly, and these are some of our newer notes, that avocado does produce a chemical, and the name of that chemical is called, I have my notebook right here, it is called a pericin, a P-E-R-S-I-N, a pericin. And that chemical that avocado produces is lethal to the bird, but it's not lethal, you know, eight times out of 10, this bird is only going to go through a small discomfort, but it is going to attack his respiratory system and his heart valve. And these days, you can't go to jail without noticing that the bird has, you know, once again, jail friends. And you definitely don't want to be locked down and not have any equipment with you. You don't want to be locked down and not know anything. Not because of the bullies in jail, but because of the bullies right outside of jail, which are going to be these birds. And what's fascinating is that thermotechnology, infrared light seekers would be able to see this bird and its activity. That's something we are interested in for the jail scene and for the old folks community. And also we want to add the fact that today's date, we're proud of you, we're black, the black, the proud of me, to the Quakers, Tornado County, or Skinnies first, homeless, white, Russian, white, Nori, everybody with a deed in any community. That's for the old folks community, any community. We are proud of you. A&R is agreeing to repeat, A&R agreeing to repeat. They are proud of me. We are proud of you, they're proud of me. We're so proud of you, they're so proud of me. We're so proud of you, they're so proud of me. We're so proud of you, they're so proud of me. Okay, and for our old folks community, what we are getting is after, and we're not able to see these people, so we're not looking in the direction. We don't know if they're even around. And you get a lot of response from societies who have been putting forth the works of their time frame. And what you're getting from the old folks community is a chemical reimbursement for them, which we think is going to add 20, if not more, years. Also in the future, if this chemical thing goes good, or anything goes good, most likely we'll be using these techniques and prospering slightly towards the old folks community. The Bible has us living longer than 100 years in the future. And so all this stuff is relatively new, but is being played with all the time. Okay, I think that's going to cover a broad span as far as the Wonder Bread stuff goes. All of that is right around the corner from all this chemical stuff, and so that's what we look forward to getting into in the future. All right, we're going to give some credits over to Pray Before Conception. Those whose families prayed before conception did discover the very first intervisionary sporicles, and the sporicles led to chemicals. And so we give all of our credit to those people and everybody else. To me, if they use the stuff for evil, then they're really taking from some of our own family members at this point. And just wanted to note that. Alrighty, I think that's going to be a wrap. That's Bird Fight documentary. And it's been fun. And talk to you next time. Over and out.